Deed. Beautiful city. The archways. Great parades have come through to celebrate. The palace itself. Just feels like yesterday when I was here last. Yesterday. I believe it was, some mission back in, like, 18 ABY, or... We had to, purposely talk with the Queen. Talk about her forced retirement. After some scandalous issues popped up with the Queen, and involving some old Jedi, enemies of Empire. Yeah, those were the good days. I remember that firefight. Really? I'm a war vet here. Why are you... What? Probably should not have done that. I probably should not have shot that person, but oh well. But it's good to be back on Naboo. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in, or I guess, is it technically tuning in when it's on YouTube, or is it just watching? I'm used to tuning in, because I used to do radio, and also did some Twitch streaming, but I kind of, you know, moved away from that, but... I guess tuning is not really the right word. Anyway, thank you for you know... Clicking on the video or whatever you're doing just to watch this here. You're joining me today as we continue on the Let's Play of Star Wars Galaxies. Pretty straightforward. We're going through Legacy. After dealing with Captain Typho and Panaka, we are finally sent here on our journey to uncover these droids to work for Pooja Nabree. And Pooja Nabree. Which Pooja do we pick? As always, this is a complete reading playthrough. Meaning, I will purposely try to voice act any of the characters. Although, to be fair, I don't think I've actually had to voice act a female character yet. This might be a first. I could be wrong about that, though. I could be very well wrong about that, but. I think this is the first time I've had to do that. Should be interesting. Anyway, today we'll be looking at two main quest lines here. The Hugo Eckner quest line, and then reporting to Major Frenchels, which deals with the terrorist plot here in Naboo. Let's go ahead and get this started and get away from my role-playing shenanigans there earlier. Which, if anyone can catch that reference, which is pretty straightforward for probably any gamer and lover of Star Wars probably knows the reference, you get 500 kudo points from me, which are completely useless points that can't be used for anything, but hey, at least they feel good. Anyway, once again, disclaimer though, this is a full read-through, so any medical issues, any psychological issues, any and all issues cannot be reliable on me. Mostly because, well... I'm not the one picking the speak here. You guys are the ones listening, right? Right? Can't blame me for that. But I do apologize for any bad lip reading, miss sayings, miss anything like that, you know. Stuff that could hurt you badly. With my voice. And wow, I got a lot of standing. I mean, I lost a lot of Naboo Security Force standing. I hope I didn't just mess up Legacy doing that. Let's find out. Let's talk to Pooja here. Alright, let's see if this Pooja works. Ah. Good, you are here. Colonel Panaka told me to expect you after you finished assisting Typho. There are two assignments for you. Oh, what are those assignments? The first is to help investigate a terrorist attack that just took place here in Theed. The second is a bit more personal, and I like to keep it a bit quiet if possible. A friend, Hugo Eckner, has a dilemma which he needs assistance. Colonel Panaka assured me that you could be discreet. Now, I was like to go through and looking back at these quest lines here, which I've, you know, have them up to just see where they go. They do recommend to do Hugo's Dilemma first, which I can actually see why. I'm going to run that one first. Tell me more about Hugo's Dilemma. I'll leave it up to Hugo to fill you in the details. Okay. What about the terrorist attack? Oh, you will report to Major Harvin Franchels for more than the terrorist situation. He will let you know what you can do to help. Alright, let's go ahead and do... Alright, I'll go see Hugo. We go in here. Oh. Good, and thank you. Alright, so Hugo. Ah, there he is. Hugo Eckner. My god, look at those mutton chops. Look at that. Huh. Alright, Hugo. Oh, you're the one who, you're the one Pooja sent. I have a bit of a dilemma and I need your help. Did she tell you much? No. She said you'd fill me in. Right. Well then, this is it. My son, Karl, has gotten into a bit of trouble. Seems he has been a gambling habit and managed to lose quite a bit of money. To make matters worse, he owes money to both the Darkwalkers and the Shock Tippers. Oh, great. He owes money to both of them? Sadly, yes, and I do not have the means to pay the debts, especially with all the interest and such. Both are willing to let me work off Karl's debt to them by undertaking various tasks, mostly against their rivals. I'm hoping you can help me out with that. What do you need me to do? Well, both the Shock Tippers and the Darkwalkers, Darkwalkers view Bravo's organization as a rival and want them knocked down a peg or two. They want me to handle this kind of thing so that it cannot be attributed to them. Is there another option? Not that I've been able to devise. Pooja advised me to do what they want, or Karl will never be safe. Fine, I'll help. Dang it, Karl. You've only stayed in the house, this wouldn't be a problem. Thank you. Hopefully we'll have done this quickly and quietly. Alrighty, so, standard quest here. We are going to travel to find the Borvo thugs, pretty close by, about 1,000 meters away, so. I'm out here and call up her vehicle. I do want to clarify something that I said yesterday. I was wrong. I was wrong about the double XP. Technically, double XP is happening today, right now. So it wasn't active back then. But we should actually be leveling up quite a bit, hopefully, today. Where are they? Oh, they're over there. Okay. But don't do what I did. Don't cross the bridge. Because you'll just end up going to the wrong place. Game me. You'll find how this walker goes through water hilarious. A little hint. Do be careful when traveling around here. There are some high-level NPCs that will ruin your day. Like that level 85 wide-eyed Famba. Who will ruin your day. Okay, it's just that NPC. So anyway, after taking a wrong turn, hopefully you do not do that, you'll come and find yourself over here at a bunker. And you gotta kill thugs. Pretty straightforward. Go ahead and this one first. Thank you. And it appears that we are taking more fire than I probably should. I probably need to figure out what's going on and why my, I probably need to adjust my build or something, because something's wrong. I don't remember it being this much hassle before. God. Okay. Let him kill me. Well, we might be having a slight tutorial on what to do if your vehicle blows up. Or it's perfectly fine. Okay, then. Alright. Let's play this a little bit more tactical. Let's actually use our brains slightly. Undo that. Let's get these two over here. God, I love doing that. Yeah, what I might start doing is I might actually start adjusting up my entertainer buff. I think that might help. My entertainer buff right now is armors and bonus XP, which, as a reminder, take your daily pills. Hello? Can you hear me? Well, anyway, next is the chalk tippers. Want some crates of droid parts, so I guess you'll need to find those parts. Oh, okay. So, inside now. Pretty straightforward little place here. Database. And here's a crate. Boom. Here's another crate. Boom. Boom. I probably should have saved that for this. Here's what we're gonna do. Use that. Do that. Do that. Haha! Boom. And done. Hello, it's me again, Hugo. You know Eckner, so the Darkwalker wants some of Bravo's database systems damaged. Could you do that while you're there? Ah, they are picky. Alright, so damage to that. I'm like a lightsaber. That. Like, how much of debt did his son, you know, acquire with him? I mean, Hugo Eckner works for the palace. He can't be, you know, like, not well off. missing one. Probably outside. Probably. Did I miss one there? Back we go. That one. That's not one. Got that one. That one. That one. And we got this one. I really like walk past one or something. Oh. Hello? Apparently the a thief named Cornelius Prim has managed to annoy both the Shock Tippers and the Darkwalkers. They want him driven out of the area, or eliminated. Nasty business, that. Alrighty, so out of my blunder of missing one of the targets. Now we gotta go run off a thief or something. Okay. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Mute my cell phone, make sure that doesn't happen again. I mean, oh wait, I gotta stay in canon. Gotta mute my comm link there for a moment. Where is this map? Other side of... I probably could have traveled there, but oh well. But yeah, these quest lines seem pretty straightforward. You help an old man out with his son, who's a degenerate. You know, that's what you're going to find in most quest lines. So they're pretty straightforward. Go here, kill this thing. Sometimes you get a few things that'll pop up that'll change it a little bit. That was Eli, fellow guild member. I wonder what he's up to. Perhaps I'll make that a new YouTube series. I'll roll a spy, and it'll be a fun game of let's see what the guild members are up to when they don't know I'm around. I think that could possibly end very, very badly, so let's not do that. Okay, now I remember. So we go up to the other side of Theed. If I remember correctly, he's like hanging out here or something. That's very descriptive of me. Hey. That's a battle droid marching alongside a stormtrooper. That's, well, keep an eye out for that one traveling around Theed. They will hurt you badly. Okay. Alrighty. I believe that's the end of his quest line there. Well, that's done. But unfortunately, there's more. It gets a bit more complicated now. Complicated. Oh. Okay, first thing starts giving your body to spray. You. And level up. as that double XP comes through and makes me happy. Ooh, and a new healing ability, too. That level 2 heal, that actually might help with keeping alive. And first aid, ooh, nice. Very nice. Increasing the healing potency. Alright. What makes it more complicated? Well, the thing is that they each want me to attack the other. Fortunately, they do not know that Karl owes both of them, and it's working for each. But I can't risk them finding out. So I'm going to send you to a Shack Tipper contact and a Darkwalker contact. They can give you your next task and hopefully do so without knowing about each other. Oh, gosh. Who are these contacts? The Shock Tipper contact is Toph Hinron. The Dark Walker one is known as Jor-El Lagan Lanson, Old Man Whappersniffer. Okay. I'm sorry for saying that wrong completely. All right. Let's go ahead and work for the Dark Walkers first. Old Man Waberman Jensen, we'll have to fill you in on the details. I don't know what he'll ask of you. All right, I'll go ahead and see him. Murphy's number one. Oh, it's pretty close by, too, in town. The giant magical space horses of speed. Alright, so you come up to this guy here. He's like, finally, you're here. My superiors were very happy with you working against Bravo's gang and that lowlife thief, Promolius. Now it's time to set your particular skills against the Shock Trippers. Wait, my particular set of skills? Am I Liam Neeson now? What is it that you want me to do? I'm trying to get my horrible Liam Neeson voice there. Oh, gosh. Did I lose subscribers just for that right there? Sorry, Liam. I'm sorry, Liam. You're going to kill as many Shock Tippers as you can, unless, of course, they kill you. If possible, you'll also sabotage some of their database systems and steal some weapons research. Okay, I'll do it. Yes, yes, you will. There's no point in delay, so you might as well proceed. Let's ponder this for a moment here. I mean, okay, I get it. I'm killing both sides, so it's kind of evening itself out. But just before, we sent in the Royal Marines to wipe out the Shock Tippers and also probably the Darkwalkers, too. But technically, we're doing the dirty work for terrorists. I mean, that's kind of what they are. I mean, how else can you describe them? Your friendly neighborhood thugs? That's a long way down. And here we go. A lot of Gungans. So, you're supposed to kill some vagabonds, which I think that's just your general Shock Tippers. Find out here in a moment. Oh, okay. So we probably need to go inside the bunker to get these guys. seems oddly clear. Ah, there we go. Ah. It's not the thugs I'm looking for. These are the things I'm looking for. I'll say this much, this base is one of the more rarer bases. What I mean by that is the... What I mean by that is the fact that the bases are, Really steal my kill there. Okay, well, let's run down here and hopefully get a few more. There we go. What I was gonna say is this is one of the more interesting in the game. Most of them are, you know, modeled around the same type. You go down and they have a couple floors, or they have a branching off system. This one here should be wrong, but should have an elevator. There's only a few of them like this in the game, though, but you can find some of these cool locations around and on different planets. Okay. Later full of bones, researchers. Don't know if we're supposed to be on this level yet. Researchers. Where are the three jacks at? Wait a second. Why do they have droids in Bacta? There's all different types of level. So the freak jacks have to be here somewhere. Oh. Right there. So one. I think it was a case of all of them were just missing. Sometimes you'll find that when you're leveling up, if there's a lot of people who are doing legacy quests at the time, you'll see that the NPCs will, gone at the time, just because people are killing them. Now, let's wait a few minutes, explore around, it'll be fine. I probably should not have wasted that. Oh. Here we go. You know, I'm gonna have to clean up my inventory soon. So sad. Okay, just one more. Here, free kick. Ah, there we go. I can see why Hugo sent you to me. You did well against those, beast elf sock tippers. Continue, by corrupting their databases. Oh, ew. That's like against my religion right there, you know. Thou shalt not hurt a computer purposely. Oh well. I mean, databases in here? Don't know, but I'll double check. Oh. Probably not. I'm pretty sure they probably don't have any down here in the. Oh, you never know. But down here in the, like, I guess what? Barracks? Wing? I do apologize for if I'm slightly for lost of words today. Kinda woke up feeling kind of sorry if I'm slightly scatterbrained right now. bypass them. Which most of these NPCs you can bypass, but I guess if I really want to be getting as much XP as I could, it could be, you know, getting every single last one of them. Another one there. Which would, especially with double XP, would probably add up more. But then again, though, if I wanted to do that, there's other options than doing Legacy to grind up. I mean, I could grind up an entire character during this double XP weekend if I really put my mind to it. Now, it's a big if, though, because I can barely put my mind to anything, for that matter, so... We'll see. Did I grab this one? I did. Here. Nothing in here. Here. I'm pretty sure they're downstairs. Alright, let's sneak past these researchers here. I don't want to kill them just yet because I'm pretty sure that after I'm done with clicking all these terminals and messing them up, they want me to slaughter as many of their researchers and scientists as possible. Straight up Order 66 level. That's a droid starfighter wing. Weird. Must be that. Ah, there it is. Good. Now one last thing, I think. Give me some weapons research notes from the researchers. I want to see what new toys the Shock Dippers are developing. Ooh. Okay then. So kill 12 researchers. Yeah! For science! I guess it's probably not that bad of a thing to do. I mean, they are building weapons to fight against the Naboo. And I'm pretty sure most of them are here, are probably here by choice. I mean, Star Wars isn't like this, say, grim, dark universe or something where, you know, groups like this, you know, kidnap scientists and force them to build super weapons or anything like that. Nah, these guys are totally volunteer. I mean, this one right here, he totally signed up for it. No, I didn't! And she has a long career ahead of herself with them. Or maybe it was her last day before retirement. Who knows? Doesn't matter. They're just thugs anyway. They're not even proper scientists. Let's see if I can chain a few. Okay. Chain and... Big Booma. Yeah. Wait a second. Wait. They're Now I feel really bad for killing them. I'm gonna do it anyway because I need the money. But they're just researching, you know, how to bring back HK-47. At least that series of droid. And boom. So with that, you wipe up the scientist, do a horrible deed, and you run out of the bunker. Surely what the Darkwalkers want us to do can't be this bad. Surely, this must be the worst of it. I do believe there's a collection around here. I'll just even grab it while we're here. Maybe it's not this waterfall. One of the waterfalls around here in Theed, if you walk around it, walk near it, under it, cross it, you get a collection for it, so. Maybe it's on this side. Probably not. I'll figure that out later. Also, I will say right now, we will probably only finish the Darkwalker quest. We won't do the investigating terrorist for this episode. Reason being is I do want to try to keep it around. I want to keep it around an hour per episode, and at most, and well, we've already been going for about 40 minutes here, so. That, and also I might have miscalculated time, and I might totally don't have a lab from 6 o'clock to 10 tonight. So, yeah. Well, I've got this short. I do apologize. But hey, you know, look, a lot of XP here. Well, you have done well enough, I suppose. That'll be all. You don't want anything else? Nope, nothing more. Alrighty. Oh. So, make sure you accept every, where's the journal? That's not it. You make sure you accept every quest, so. Huh, where is it? There we go. And level up. How's it going? Hope they're not asking too much, but I don't know what choice I have. I can't let them hurt my son. Tell me about the shock tipper contact. I don't know, actually. You'll have to talk to him. Alright, I'll just go speak to him. Well, good luck. Jeez. Oh. Perhaps if your son didn't gamble so much, or you raised him better, he wouldn't have had this trouble in the first place. Why aren't you out here doing it? I mean, you seem capable. Okay, maybe not. But still, I'm pretty sure his son's probably good with a blaster, right? And what worse could go wrong with, you know, playing against two criminal organizations or terrorist organizations when your son's involved, right? This is gonna end badly, isn't it? Well, you know what? Here he is. Bald is in, apparently. You're here for Eckner, right? Good. Here's the deal. You're going to hit those lousy Darkwalkers where they live. Make sure they feel it. If you do a good job, all debts will be erased and the Eckner kid won't owe us anything. Well, until next time. What exactly do you want me to do? You're going to go attack some Darkwalkers and make them feel some pain, and I think you'll steal me some access codes and some security cards. Unlimited access to their base might come in handy. Fine, I'll do it. Want to do it? Of course you will. It's not like you ever had a choice. I don't like that. Not like I ever had a choice. Why don't I just go back to their base and, like, slaughter them and execute their leader like I did earlier, too? That's a choice. Note to self. Return to them and apply Great Clone Vengeance. When I'm not being lazy. Oh, yay. Get to go cave diving. So, anyway. It's pretty straightforward. We literally do the exact same thing here. It's almost the exact same quest, just different named NPCs. I believe we can kill some of them outside, though. No, we can't. Oh, time to go diving. So one complaint I have about MMO design, I really don't like the whole go here, kill five things. Okay, that's not too bad. That's classic MMO design. But I also know that I'm gonna have to go and click on all those terminals later and find key cards, and all that means is I'm gonna have to kill them again and click on all the terminals and potentially have to fight them all again. And I'm also I'm also running out of inventory space. Let's dump stuff that we can't sell. Buy lightsaber crystals. Oh, yeah. Flip that. Wait a second. What did I unequip? Did something wrong here. Oh, I should probably equip that. Whoops. Okay. Note to self, after this episode, clean inventory, because I have not done that. Journal. We're just going to figure out what that quest is later. Let's throw that into the backpack. And this fragmentation grenade. And my shirt. Backpack. I'm sorry for failing so hard right now. This is ridiculous. Well, we'll figure this out later. Dude, what did he drop? Chemical recycling, don't care. Most of the stuff is just junk anyway, but you can get a decent amount of credits if you farm up junk. Especially if you farm up like stacks of junk and sell them, because it's used for stuff like, say, 32s and other fun things that make the game just better. Stuff I normally don't worry about until after I'm level 90 and, you know, grinding up money. I wonder. Completely a waste of that, but totally worth it. That's a name guard. No, get back here. You gotta blow up. There we go. You know, this could be a pretty good PSA here. An anti-gambling PSA. Don't do gambling. Otherwise, some poor random person will have to go and do your father's dirty work to get you out of your debt. Me. Yeah, okay. I guess that's enough for now. Instead, I need you to download some Darkwalker security codes from the computer caves. Oh, okay. So... this? Instead of destroying the computers this time, though, we're downloading from 9 computers. Wait, what's this up here? Is this potentially spoilers alert? Help me, please! I just wanted to make enough money to impress that Argonian maid. Wait, sorry, wrong universe. You know, that would be an interesting series. And by interesting, I mean that would be a series that I don't think people would like. Actually, maybe. Reading the books of Elder Scrolls Online. All 14,000 of them. Can you just imagine that? I mean, I have trouble, you know, fathoming the fact that they apparently have 14,000 books. Which, granted, when they say books, we're talking like, you know, 1 to 2 pages, 3 at the most. But still, that's a decent amount of writing when you add it up on there. I mean, that's at least more than a couple of novels worth. That'll be the series. Epically bad reading of Elder Scrolls novels. By Jackson Pavan. We'll start off with the Argonian Maid series, part 1 and part 2. I would start to recite it now, but one, I don't know, I don't have the full story memorized, and two, I'm pretty sure actually you flag me for that. What are you doing in this cave? What I want to know is, okay, why is a terrorist organization allowed to inhabit a cave system right underneath the main starport in Theed? Like, where's the sense in that? I mean, okay, from a gameplay sense, it makes perfect sense, because you don't want it too far away. You want to keep your players engaged and going back and forth and, you know, hooked to it. And if you have to travel long distances, it starts to get grinding. Well, it's already grinding, but worse. But from a tactical standpoint, how does Naboo, or the Empire for that matter, who is technically controlling Naboo, letting a bunch of terrorists get away with this? And I think I have to go the other way, don't I? Yes, I do. I mean, if I was the Imperial Garrison leader, I mean, even if I was just the Royal Marine leader for Naboo, I would march my garrison straight down into this pit and kill them all. That, or, you know, there's not really much ventilation. You could use, I don't know, you could, like, put some, like, gas or something. Not, that sounds horrible. You could use some gas to knock them out and then arrest them all. That's more ethical, right? We're not the Empire, right? Also, I don't even want to question what a Darkwalker grinder is. Which, knowing a lot of these thuggy gangs, which are probably made up of, like, teenagers, you know, they probably think, oh, that's an edgy name. Yeah, we're gonna be the Darkwalkers. And we're gonna have ranks, too. Oh, what, like, private, corporal, lieutenant? No. Drudge. And Raffle. And Scoff. It doesn't make sense. It makes perfect sense. There probably is some, like, lore story or something for why their names are like this, and I'm just completely missing it. Alright, there's another one. Ah, there's the last one. Alright, let's see what they want us to do. Right, well that's done. I got the codes, but we also need security cards. Get those from the Sentinels. Oh, great. So let's run back this way. I really did these out of order. See, this is, once again, going back to what I was saying before, I really wish MMO Design would just, like, say, give me all the stuff to do up front. I mean, I know they're trying to drag it out for subscription reasons, but, you know, would it really hurt that I can, you know, hack the terminals while fighting the enemies? You really need to drag it out, maybe give me more enemies to kill. Instead of, you know, but let me just do everything at the same time. I mean, not that it matters now, since this game is obviously free, and you know, I probably shouldn't be complaining, but if somehow an MMO designer out there is watching this, or someone who's going to be working in game design, and you're going to join a team for an MMO, and, you know, somehow do, you know, classic MMO-style stuff, well, maybe take this to heart slightly. Who knows? And we're definitely not going to be under the 1 hour mark. Yay! It's kind of funny. I was originally thinking of coming back to this and doing short episodes, focusing on one quest each. But I find it easier to do, like, you know, the quest chains, because essentially these quest chains are just almost like their own quest. But there's, but even a single quest line is going to take about an hour normally, just running around. Oh look, we gotta kill 12 more of these. Huh, I wonder, what this sounds like. It's almost like the original devs copied and pasted something. There's someone down there? Work? Did it work? It worked. I'm fast. You survived that? How? I better heal. Of course, I shoot the wrong one. See if we can crumb them all together in one nice little blob here. I'm gonna go the other way. I don't want to trigger the. I don't want to kill the main guy just in case I need to turn around and kill him. I'm pretty sure I will end up having to kill him if I attack that sense. So we'll go down here and shoot the other one. Like two over here. There we go. And done. So surely this is all that's left to do. There's nothing bad that won't happen, and clearly what's his gambling face will be off the hook and we don't have to worry about it. Alright. Right? Probably not. I might just have to cut this here in the sense that I might not have any inventory space soon. That guy's scary looking. Oh yeah, you did good. Really good, yeah. Alright, complete this quest. Ding, level up. No, you're done. Go away now. I've got some other things to deal with for the moment. Okay. So, we're gonna head back to Hugo and, you know, see that everything's fine and our journey's been successful. We don't have to worry about his kid anymore, right? I'm being really sarcastic, and I should probably stop that. Ooh, Signet of Aganta. Might as well wear that. Proposed... Oh, okay. Wait a second. Wait a second. Did that give me an option to propose unity to my ATRT? More importantly, why is it not letting me propose unity to my ATRT? I mean... My ATRT has feelings. These are all junk anyway. All the color crystals and stuff. Good for decoration, but I have like 100 of them back in my supply shack, so. Here we go, Hugo. No! No! We've done everything that they asked, and yet my son has not been released. I have no other choice. There's only one option left. Okay, what is that option? I need you to rescue my son, Karl. I know this might put his life at risk. Not to mention yours as well, but I see no other way. No worries, I'll rescue him. Thank the Force! Wait, that's heresy. You shouldn't be talking like that. The first problem is I don't know if the Shock Tippers have Karl or if the Darkwalkers do. Whichever it is, you'll most likely be at their base near Theed. You'll have to search for them until you find Karl. Which would you like to start? I'm gonna cheat and say we're gonna go to the Darkwalker cave. Thank you, please hurry. There's no time to waste. I know I probably shouldn't cheat for that, but I know he's there. Because what's going to happen is you go to the Darkwalker cave, you look around. Actually, what if it... I'm gonna double check that, because, you know... Maybe it will switch it. Who knows? Let's see. Nope, he is for sure in the... Okay. But he is for sure. We know for a fact he's in the Darkwalker Cave. He does not switch locations to the other place. So that is good to know. I don't know why I thought the game might be that specialized to do that, but... Okay. We know for a fact that he's in the cave. I guess if you want a little bit, if you want a little bit extra XP, you can go murder people at the other place. But I don't recommend it. I mean, you're getting 12,000 XP as it is. In this case, I'll probably get another. I probably won't get another level up, but a close to one. Probably take my vitamins again. But, you know, just save yourself some time and go to the Darkwater Cave. You're not missing out on anything by going there. I don't think I've actually ever done the first part, going back to the Chalk Tipper place back on live, so... Technically, it doesn't exist. I'm gonna waste time. Run past these people who should be dead. And there he is. Karl! Who are you? Can you help me? Your father sent me to rescue you. My father? Didn't he do what they asked? Yes, but they still will not release you. Oh, I see. I guess I need your help then. I've overheard them, wait. I forgot, I was able to walk through that? Why can't you just walk through it, bro? I overheard them talking, so I know that you'll need 3 codes to release me. I got get the codes and use them in the prisoner constraint control over there. Add me to the access list so I can use the console to free myself. Oh, I get it. It's like one of those bomb collars or something from Tatooine. How do I get the codes? Darkwalker's leaders have them. Talon Ga, Petolius Massey, and Marcus Ga. You'll have to take the codes from them. I'll be back when I kill them all. Alrighty, so. Need to first defeat Salon Ga. So, go ahead and target him. See where he at. He's down here. Once again, there's 3 of them at the kill. I have to kill them in order. I don't know what the respawn timer is, but all that means is I've got to run around a lot more. Hopefully there's like a sense of order or something, but of where to, you know, where to meet him. But if not, then, you know, there's a high chance I'm just going to run around this cave for half an hour trying to find random NPCs. Well, maybe not that long, but there he is. And first code. Boom goes the dynamite. And yes, I did just make that reference. Alright, where's Crit? I have a feeling he... another game. We might actually hit an hour and a half. I don't think we will, but we'll see. Yeah, I'm starting to think that he is in the other side. Yes, on the bright side, if he's on this side, there's nowhere else for him to hide, so I can just murderize them all and get this done quickly. So, we should be done here in a few minutes. Hopefully. I will say this much, though. Certain newer games have definitely spoiled me when it comes to MMO quest design. I mean, they are still pretty much the same thing when you get down to it. Go here, kill these things, but at least, you know, other games are kind of, you know, innovating slightly. Like for example, I've been recently kicking around ESO with some friends of mine, and I have to admit, it's been quite enjoyable. I think a lot of the same thing here. Go to a place and do this and do that, but you have interesting interactions the whole way, you know, voice acted NPCs most of the time. Some of them I've noticed have been messed up. The quests are a little bit more than just, you know, kill all these things and be over with it. Alright, let's tenderize him. Alright, second code. I want to deal with you guys. I will say this much, though. This does bring a... It brings back so many memories doing this Let's Play, but also so many memories of just past MMO experiences that could have been so much better. I mean, I'm not saying I'm not having fun. It just, it's not really dated. It's just, you know, old school. Yeah, we'll use that word. And third bloodboard. All right. I will say, though, I have played some pretty grindy MMOs out there, that's for sure. Some of them that would try to do that whole storyline thing but kind of fail, you know, when it comes to the actual grind themselves. Stuff comes to mind is like Arc Age. I played through that a couple years ago, and I don't remember any of the actual grind itself. It was kind of all blurred together. It was a case of just go here, do quest after quest after quest, and... get it over with. At least when it comes to Star Wars, I remember parts of it, you know? Maybe it's just because it's my first MMO or something, but... I will say, the hard grind part is you know... something that's, I guess, a standard of MMOs, so it's always going to be there. But it's not always my favorite part, that's for sure. Okay, oh, wait. Now that you have the access codes, use the prisoner constraint console on the gate to override the security access on the control, okay. Ooh, there we go. I'm free! I almost cannot believe it. Thank you very much. I'll ask you out of here. That's not necessary. Now that I have access to the prisoner constraint console, I can deactivate these cell bars and make my own way out. But thank you. Please let my father know that I'm free. Tell him I'll be there soon. If not before you. Oh, okay. I'll take that challenge. I think I can beat you home. I will say, though, for the quest for this game, though, even though they are pretty much, you know, the same, go here, kill that, kill this, kill that, over and over again, there is some variety as you go along. And the story is, you know, slightly entertaining? I'm not gonna say, I mean, there's a story to it, at least. Plus, some of your rewards you get are just, you know, hilarious. Like, oh, let's do police work and I'm gonna give you some donuts, or let's get the body spray. I mean, I get it, they're buff items, but where is it? Did not save it in here, did I? Oh, did I delete it? No! Oh, there it is. Yeah, increase your luck with Hugo's body spray. Hugo's body spray, increase your luck. Did they really just give me Axe body spray for a quest item? Did that really just happen? Yes. Yes, it did. I think that's why I kind of, you know, maybe that's why I enjoy, you know, Legacy compared to other MMOs. There's other MMOs, oh, here's a sword, here's a weapon, which they give you weapons and stuff. But just some of the junk they gave you is just funny. Like, I'll go stick that in my home or something in this game and just stick it up there. Not really moss growing up that? Never noticed that before. Weird. But, you know, I'll just stick them in, you know, random places of decoration, because they're just weird. Congratulations, working for the police. Here's a pastry. Or, if you want that Nabooian noble smell, use Hugo's body spray. Yeah. It'll definitely increase your luck. Thank you! Karl is back! I've made sure he's safe. Thank you for everything. Is there anything else I can do? Well, I guess you need to return to Pooja and speak with her. But as far as I'm concerned, you've already accomplished more than I could have dare hoped. Thank you very much. Whew. Well. That was a thing. Let's see what Pooja says to us. Oh. Okay. Continue your assignments, Trooper. I've solved Hugo's dilemma and his son. Carl's safe now. Thank you. I appreciate your discretion, with that assignment. Hugo has been a friend Hugo has been a friend to my family for a long time. So I didn't want to see him suffer. Hopefully Carl learned his lesson. And we get a necklace. And a lot of XP. And a level up. That makes me happy. I am glad I could help. Now, no rest for the worry, I'm afraid. Your next assignment will be to investigate a terrorist attack that just took place in Theed. What do I need to do? You will report to Major Harvin Frenchels for more on the terrorist situation. He'll let you know what you can do to help. Alright then, I'll report to him. Excellent, good luck. But I think before I do that... I'm gonna take a break. Yeah, that's a pretty long quest today. So we're gonna go and wrap it up here at just a little bit short of an hour and a half. So I do want to thank you all for watching. This once again was going through the Hugo Eckner side of Pooja and Bree's questline. So this will be a full two-parter. You know, we'll do the other part with dealing with terrorists tomorrow, probably. I'll try to get hit tomorrow, if not Sunday. I might not do it tomorrow because I do have Saturday classes, so, you know. It'll be coming soon. We'll be doing it soon, I promise. Totally promise. Totally will not get sick and disappear for 2 weeks again. Nope. Won't happen. But yeah, we will definitely be continuing this this quest line here. Until then, though, I want to thank you all for watching. Thank you all for putting up with me and my horrible voice acting. And sorry if I was kind of quiet on the quiet today, you know. Kind of, as I said, have been feeling kind of eh in this episode, but needs to get done. We got to level up Gant. Eventually, he'll be 90 one day, and then it'll be over. I'm going to something better. Like, I don't know, grinding 35s. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. That'll be fun once we get to there. But first things first, let's get through Legacy. So once again, I want to thank you for watching. I want to thank you for being a subscriber, or if you're a future subscriber, thank you for subscribing. May the Force be with you all, and you all have a good day.